China's implementation of the technology in products and services is likely to edge ahead of the U.S. this year.
China's biggest search engine, Baidu, have announced ChatGPT rival.
It's called ChatGPT.
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 Since last year, ChatGPT dominated global headlines, articles and videos about Chinese AI technology emerged a lot. Many people expressed their optimistic views, including some points from Chinese AI companies and Elon Musk's point about a one-year gap. The future of Chinese AI technology will be terminated? Well, that sounds like a joke. Initially, I was also optimistic, believing China had the potential to be the future leader in this era. Because China has rich experience on the internet and many global tech companies like ByteDance and Alibaba. However, after going deep into the cutting-edge level of AI and Chinese AI tools, I realized that the gap between Chinese and American AI technology is much larger than we imagined. And the problems also represent a current dilemma for Chinese technology industry. Hey guys, I'm Max. Since the release of ChatGPT 4th generation, there have been huge differences in its performance between Chinese and English language expressions. To be honest, its English language is much better, mostly because OpenAI's 90% of training database is English data and only 0.1% Chinese. However, it's surprising that the Chinese language expression is not that bad either. So why? Firstly, let's look at how our brain expresses foreign languages. I believe for most people, especially rookies, prefer translating English to your native language mentally, organizing your ideas, and then translating them back to English. This double translation process is the biggest obstacle to have fluency in English, and also the big reason why reaching native level proficiency in a foreign language has always been challenging. Native speakers, on the other hand, have an end-to-end language output process, which makes better language expression and fluency. Actually, ChatGPT operates on a similar principle. In OpenAI's model, many foreign languages, including Chinese, learn their expression through the lens of English rather than native language thinking. AI models rely on language principles of our brain to perform translations. This is why a huge number of softwares can recognize articles generated by AI, even if ChatGPT combines the context of English databases into a single Chinese paper. The characteristics of English expression can be completely eliminated. However, AI models are not human brains. They only sample based on distributions. Eventually, only languages like English and some other Latin language, like French and Italian, can achieve state-of-the-art levels, which means best performance. Languages like Chinese and Korean can't reach the same level. Even if ChatGPT has impressive capabilities and can satisfy most daily communications through back translation, the actual gap between the Chinese and English language abilities is already at completely different levels. In the future, with AI model upgrades and the Matthew effect of data, this gap is likely to be much bigger. Since the global Chinese database referenced by ChatGPT is already small, what about the database in mainland China? Unfortunately, much more terrible. And this is the first reason that hampers China's AI technology. You know, when you ask AI about the source of an answer, it will provide a list of referenced data sources. Therefore, the accuracy of AI's responses heavily relies on the availability of high-quality data. The more and better the data is, the stronger the AI will be. So data is more like a gasoline for AI engine. However, it's unfortunate that high-quality databases in China are depleting. 10 years ago, when Chinese internet was just rising, there were over 10 million high-quality forums, blogs, and websites in China. However, a decade later, this number dropped to 5 million, and it decreased by over 250,000 just in 2022. For example, some excellent public discussion and popular science platforms have faced bankruptcy due to the early unregulated environment of China's internet and excessive monopolization of data by large companies. Even some remaining high-quality platforms, such as Zhihu, is not that good anymore. Academic knowledge field is terrible too. You know, there are a lot of fraudulent and low-quality papers in Chinese academic databases, which have been frequently exposed by international organizations in recent years. Many universities and government institution databases suffer from issues like missing data and low-quality literature. Finally, when Chinese people search for some data like Chinese economy, they even have to use VPNs to access the overseas databases. Another crisis is government regulation. Since last decade, China's internet censorship has reached a suffocating level. Even on the remaining knowledge sharing platforms, apart from precise AI censorship, there are also various forms of manual censorship, with the prohibition of discussing politically, economically, culturally, and socially sensitive topics, ranging from the history of Communist Party to LGBTQ, from market economy to religion. Almost every knowledge and social topics have forbidden areas. In order to evade censorship, a phenomenon called Yin-Yang expression has emerged on Chinese internet in recent years. It involves not directly expressing certain topics, but discussing them indirectly. For example, discussing A, but pretending to talk about B. Numerous metaphors, substitute words, and even historical stories to allude to current topics are very common. For example, many sensitive people's names are often replaced by that man in discussions. This inefficient way is not easily understandable even for many native Chinese, and I guess it will be very challenging for AI too. Furthermore, strict regulations result in a flood of useless information on China's online platforms. Well, we know the problem of irrelevant information exists worldwide, but English databases are much larger than Chinese. For example, there are 100 million Chinese data entries, with high-quality data accounting for 1%, and after filtering, it will provide around 1 million entries for AI training. On the other hand, there are 200 million English data entries with 5% high-quality content, then forms a database of 10 million entries. Consequently, the trained English model would have a much larger quantity and a better performance than Chinese. So the actual gap could be much larger than tenfold. Finally, such a poor and limited database can only make a strange AI model. The second reason is data enclosure. 10 years ago, many Chinese internet companies used their databases as one of the advantages to help their IPOs and fundraising. As a result, a large amount of data was locked. And they also blocked data crawlers from accessing their databases. Their training data was never made available to the public. Even China's best search engine, Baidu, is far behind Google, no matter on search quality or quantity. Eventually, Baidu had to make profit by showing low-quality ads. Unlike Google, where you can get many useful answers on the first page, Chinese search engines are often filled with virus ads. This led to multiple public crises related to fake ads. By the way, this issue is one of the reasons why Chinese government wanted to regulate a monopoly of internet companies. The third reason is technological sanction. China's previous internet miracle was largely because of the diffusion of American internet technologies. Since the release of first iPhone in 2007, China, as the global factory, imported Apple's production lines, enabling Chinese smartphone companies to rapidly learn from Apple's product model and create multiple smart hardware companies such as Xiaomi and Huawei. China also became the world's strongest electric product manufacturing base. The cooperation with Android system, imitation of American internet platforms, and learning from cheap technologies made Chinese companies to catch up with the forefront in various fields. However, in 2023, the United States implemented comprehensive technological sanctions on China, especially the chip design and manufacturing, which is the source of internet technology. The sanction on GPU technology will also restrict the speed of Chinese AI. Additionally, ChatGPT is inaccessible in Chinese region, including Hong Kong and Macau. Therefore, the United States aims to completely exclude China from the list of participants in the AI revolution. Industries such as cloud services, supercomputing, and AI model design, all relying on AI chips produced by TSMC and GPUs from NVIDIA. These limitations would definitely slow down the advancement of Chinese AI technology. Something more terrible is that AI-assisted capabilities will weaken one of the Chinese previous advantages, engineers. For example, in the past, China's large number of network engineers and their efficiency made them to handle many projects. However, with the help of AI, the advantages of engineers will decline both in quantity and quality. Well, after seeing these reasons, you might think that China's AI technology is completely out of the game. But you know, it's not that desperate. China's internet giants and the government are actively catching up, no matter the release of virus AI tools or the new financing plans. However, all of these efforts just began after the birth of OpenAI, so it's nearly impossible to see China become a leader in AI technology in the future. But about future direction of AI applications, Chinese companies seem to be smarter, and that is internet regulation and censorship by using AI. Just after the release of virus AI models last year, Chinese government quickly issued AI regulatory provisions. Therefore, even if Chinese AI is smart enough in the future, there are definitely some certain questions they refuse to answer, or they will give you some strange answers you totally have no idea. Thank you guys for watching, and hopefully subscribe, ring the bell, and leave some comments if you like. See you next time.